Hey guys, my name is Scoby. Today I'm going to be showing you how to play Gameboy Advance games on Mac. This is going to be a nice, quick and easy tutorial. I'm going to be showing you step by step how to get everything up and running. Let's jump right into this. So the first thing I want to do is come to this website. Links are always in the description down below. And we're going to be downloading Boycott Advance 0.4.0. You want to come down here, click the download button right here, and your download will begin. It's a pretty small download. It's under a megabyte. So what you want to do is get that downloaded and then move it to a location where you can find it easily. I currently have my Boycott Advance on my desktop alongside Pokemon Emerald. Once you have it downloaded, you want to double click to open Boycott Advance. And you may get this pop-up message saying that Boycott Advance cannot be opened because it's an unidentified developer. I'm going to be showing you step-by-step how to get rid of this. What you want to do is click OK. We're going to click the little Mac logo on the top left, and we're going to go to System Preferences. Once you're in System Preferences, you want to go to Security and Privacy, and down here at the bottom you should have a little pop-up message saying Boycott Advance was blocked from opening because it is not from an identified developer. What you want to do is click on the right to click Open Anyway. You want to click Open one more time, and then you want to enter the credentials of the admin of the PC, or you might have to enter the password of the account you're currently on if you are already the admin, to allow the software to be entered and to be able to be opened up. Once you have this done, the application will automatically open. What you have to do is just close down the actual System Preferences, and in the background Boycott Advance is open. From here you want to just locate to where your games are. So currently I have mine on my desktop. I'm not going to be showing you today's video or to download games, but games are really, really easy to find. A quick Google search will help you out, and you can find any Gameboy Advance games you want to play. Games will usually come in a .zip folder. What you want to do is extract out the .gba game files from this folder, open it up with Boycott, and then your games will run perfectly. And it's as simple as that to play Gameboy Advance games on your Mac. I'm just going to be showing you a couple of settings in Boycott just so you know your way around the software now. What you want to do is go up to the top left, and we're going to be clicking on Boycott Advance, and we're going to be going to Preferences. And from here we can edit all the settings. The first thing you want to do is go to Video, and you want to set the frame rate to automatic. This will stop any frame skipping or jumping in the actual software. You can also display frame rate if you want to have a look at that. Underneath the interface, we can select a couple different settings to run the game at the actual speed, or we can change the volume at the bottom of the interface. In the emulator, I wouldn't really change any of these settings. You can play around with them if you wish, but I'd recommend leaving them alone. And then finally, on the joysticks, we're going to be able to set up controllers, and we're going to be able to set up the keyboard. The keyboard is a little tricky to set up, but I'm going to be showing you how to do it step by step right now. So what you're going to do is click on Configure Keyboard. Most people would assume you would click on the key you wish to use, and then it would give you a bunch of options of what the actual Game Boy buttons would have, and you can select accordingly to that. But in this case, you have to drag around the different controls and select which one you want by dragging and moving. It's a little bit more complicated than some of the other software I've seen, but it does work. It's just a little bit confusing. Once you've all your selected settings in the right place, you can click OK, and then you can start playing your game. And that's how you play Gameboy Advance games on Mac. It's a pretty simple tutorial. There's just a couple little things that need to be shown. Otherwise, if you've never done it before, it can be a little bit complicated, but it's pretty easy overall. Anyway guys, if you enjoyed this tutorial, be sure to drop a like, subscribe if you're new, check out the other videos on the channel. I'm going to be making some more Mac emulator tutorials in the future. This is the first one over here in the channel, but there will be more to come. If you found this video helpful and you want to support the channel, I'm going to leave my PayPal link down below. Of course, there's no pressure if you can't. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching. Until next time, as always, keep it saucy. Peace.